Hey everyone, it's me, Wendy. Today I'll be showing you how I made my own really, really easy straw bag. Ta-da! These have been really popular lately. They're very classic and they kind of just add a happy adventure type of vibe to every outfit. I'll get right into the tutorial and then afterwards I've included a blog post with a whole bunch of options I found online for different straw materials that you can use, so just kind of saving you a little bit of hunting. These bags can come in all sorts of shapes and sizes, so I thought it would be nice to kind of do some exploring for you. I have been doing a sponsored series with Squarespace to show all their website building features and how I use them for my YouTube channel, and this is the last video in that series. Stick around until the end so you can see the blog post that I included for you, and we will get right into the tutorial. The key to this DIY is two straw placemats. I've been on the hunt for round ones and finally got my hands on these two. The next item you need to get is wide burlap or woven ribbon. This can be found at the fabric or craft store, but make sure it's thick and strong. Cut the ribbon so that it can go along the outside of the placemat with an opening at the top, and then fold in the edges so that we can hem the ends. Here's how those hemmed edges look. I did a zigzag along the edge to prevent them from fraying, and then folded it over and added a straight stitch to give it a nice clean fold. Now we can clip the ribbon to the placemat and sew all the way around with a straight stitch. Ta-da! Our wall is up and the straight stitch is hardly noticeable on the outside as long as you use matching thread. We'll repeat that for the second placemat and the bag's body is done. For the straps, I used some matching twine and an old leather belt that I had. There's probably a great belt waiting for you at your local thrift store. This belt is kind of a cool feature because if you adjust the belt, you can change the length of one or two of the straps. So depending on how you use the belt, you can make it into an adjustable feature. I closed my belt on the smallest hole and then clipped it so that it would lay completely flat. This let me cut through the two sides to get two symmetrical pieces. Make sure though that this length is long enough to go comfortably over your shoulder and attach to the bag. In my case, that was at least 46 centimeters, so don't go any lower than that. I measured the width of the belt and then used that to add four symmetrical markings that formed a square. These are going to be punched into holes, so do make sure that they're not too close to the edge. Once all my leather holes had been punched, I attached the belt to the top of the bag on all four ends. With my twine, I tied a knot and put it through a nice and thick needle, then I sewed through the holes to form an X shape. I didn't feel quite secure about just going through each hole once, so I did go through twice and I did a like layered stitches thing to form a small weave in the middle. And that finishes the bag. Dan and I recently went on a really big West Coast road trip and I brought this bag along, which made it perfect for the coast. Something about it just looks so good by the beach and with the rocks and when you're out walking. We will put out a vlog very soon of that trip. I'm super excited for it because every single day of that trip, I wore something that I DIY'd. And if you've made your own items before, I think you can relate that it feels awesome. If you liked how this bag turned out, do not forget to subscribe. You can also find me on Instagram. It is at Withwendy. I mentioned in the tutorial that this belt lets you have an expandable strap, so I'll demonstrate that because I don't think I actually showed how that worked. But basically, right now, they're the same length. You can undo one of them. Move it up. Let's take it to the last hole. Slide that back in. And so now obviously they're not the same length anymore, but what I've been doing is, oh yeah, I go like this wear it like this, and then it's basically got a little bit more swing room to it. Not a huge change, but just kind of a cute perk, I guess. If you check the description, there is a link there for you that goes through a couple more straw-related things I found on the internet, since these ones were straw placemats, but there's all sorts of other straw surfaces that could be changed into a bag for you. My whole website is a Squarespace website, which is pretty fast, easy, looks professional, and lets me put up some kind of like supplementary, more detailed content for my tutorials. If you have been wanting to start a new website, I really do recommend Squarespace, and you can start a free trial today. There is a link in the description for you and an offer code. It is with Wendy, and that gets you 10% off your first purchase. Hope you all liked how this bag turned out. I've been meaning to make one of these for a long time, so I've been on the hunt for the right straw for me. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye! This video is made possible by my Patreon supporters. If you would like to support me on Patreon too, go to patreon.com.